Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ashley. I'm an intern architect in Canada. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to become a licensed architect in Canada. So stay tuned. One of the first steps to becoming a licensed architect is your education. That is your benchmark. In Canada, there are 11 universities that offer accredited programs. There are some schools that take in students from interdisciplinary backgrounds, and other schools that only take in students with an undergraduate degree in architecture. Another way to get your education requirement to become a licensed architect is through the syllabus program. One of the advantages, I would say, from the syllabus program is you're actually making income. Because in university, it's actually very difficult to hold a job while you're studying full-time. So I would say that is an advantage from the syllabus program. And also gaining that practical experience is very valuable. So I believe that the syllabus program is a strong contender if that's something you're looking into. I didn't go through the syllabus program, I went through the university route. Anyways, that's a whole separate video that we can talk about more. Comment down below if you want to learn more about the syllabus program. So step number two to becoming a licensed architect is experience. You have to log about 3,720 hours minimum, which is about 2 years of professional experience. Now, before you begin logging that experience, you need to register as an intern architect. I'm gonna have a future video about how to become an intern architect in Canada. So once you're registered as an intern architect, you're able to begin logging your experience. Now, it doesn't always take 2 years because you gotta get hours in each category. So for example, you're gonna need hours, a particular amount of hours in contract admin, in design, in building code, and in planning. So you have to meet all those requirements, and that can be challenging. So depending on the office and where you work, or depending on what you do, it can be challenging to meet all those hours. So you may not get it done in 2 years, which is fine because not everyone gets all those hours done in 2 years. So what I've learned in the process is to be patient about the process and to just be patient about those hours that, you know, you're not going to get it done in 2 years. And I mean, you're going to do your best to get those hours, but it's going to be difficult to get them all done in one shot. Step number three, examinations. So in order to become a licensed architect, you also need to write exams. There are two options, and depending on the province in which you reside, there may only be one option. So it's important for you to check your jurisdiction and see what requirements are needed. For example, in Ontario, you could write the ARE, which is an American-based exam. And then you have the EXAC exam, which is a Canadian-based exam. So in Ontario, the ARE is recognized. Basically, you have two options. You can write the ARE or the EXAC exam. I wrote the EXAC exam. It was a two-day process. So you have to make sure you prepare for the exams. And I'll be doing future videos on how to prepare, giving you guys some tips. So make sure to subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell for future videos. So to write the exam, you only need 2,800 hours. That's to write the EXAC exam. So you don't need to have 3,720 hours to write. So you don't have to complete your full set of hours of experience. You could start writing the exam with just 2,800 hours, should you choose to. So once you pass the exams, the great thing is, you're able to apply to become an architect. You're officially an architect. So you can apply, and depending on the province in which you reside, there are different documents that you have to fill out. Also, if you choose to open your own company, there might be a second stage to the process. So for example, in Ontario, you need a certificate of practice if you want to have your own company. So that adds an additional stage to the process. But if in some provinces that isn't a requirement, just being a licensed architect is enough. You can open your own company and you have your stamp and seal, and so you could do that. But in Ontario, you do need to have your certificate of practice as well. So there you have it. Those are the three steps to becoming a licensed architect in Canada. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you got some value out of the video, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification button for future videos. See you guys next time.
Bye!